Hey, this is John Carlos, here again with another review, this time of the Star Wars Black Series action figure of Wrecker from the Bad Batch. Now, the Black Series figures tend to go for a more realistic movie look. So whenever they adapt figures from Clone Wars or Rebels, they have to take some artistic license to give them a more realistic look. And as far as taking the Bad Batch and adapting their heads into this sort of style of the Bad Batch, this is my favorite head sculpt. This is my favorite translation. I think it really reads like Wrecker. I love the sculpt on the eye. I love the scarring on the face. Some really nice details. That smirk, you really get his personality. I feel like this is what he would look like in live action. The armor looks great. Some nice details as far as the angles of the sculpt. Some nice little silver paint for where like things have been kind of scratched and nicked. I like the Clone Force 99 logo on the side. The burgundy things look good. All the little details of his armor. I especially like the angles of it all. It looks really, really good. I'm very, very happy with the sculpt. We have this little knife sheath on the side. We'll get to that in a moment when we take a look at the accessories. But the paint is clean. The sculpting is nice. Articulation is pretty solid. I mean, I'm not showing you details with the articulation, but I've played with it, and I've wiggled the joints, and they're all fine. Accessories include this backpack. I think it's my favorite of all the backpacks that the Bad Batch figures have come with. I like the red and blue paint details on it. It's nicely sculpted. We have this very familiar looking blaster, but it's a good sculpt. I think the blaster looks nice, even though it's just one basic plastic color. The helmet is awesome looking. I think they absolutely nailed the details on this helmet. The paint job on it is awesome. It's got a little bit of a squish to it. It's not super solid, but not super squishy. It's just the right amount of squish for squeezing over a figure's head. And then we have this knife. It's very simple, but a good sculpt. I like the handle, and it fits very nicely into the little leg sheath like so, and I think it looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and put the helmet on Wrecker's head. Plugs in really good, and I'm happy with the articulation once it's on. You can actually get some decent head tilting, some good personality. I thought we might lose a bit of that with the neck space there, but it actually works out really, really well. Lastly, let's go ahead and just plug this onto the back of the figure. The little outer armor wiggles over the hole, so you have to get them to line up a bit, but it's not too drastic of a wiggle, and it does stay on nicely. So here he is all fully assembled, and I gotta say, he looks really, really good. If you're a fan of Wrecker, I feel like there's not a lot to dislike about how this figure's been handled, except for one thing. It's a deluxe Black Series figure, which means it's $29.99, and I'm beginning to have a real problem with Hasbro and what they consider to be deluxe figures. They charge $29.99 for what makes this deluxe. He comes with a helmet, a gun, a little backpack, and a knife. What, he's a little bit wider than the other people in the Bad Batch? He's a little bit taller? Like, deluxe figures, sure, like the Gamorrean Guard, it's a bigger figure. I get certain figures being deluxe. This is should be a regular release, and the fact that it's not, I find to be irritating and kind of price gougy. Look, here's Wrecker with the rest of the Bad Batch, and he's barely taller than Hunter. He's barely taller than Tech. This does not qualify him to be a deluxe figure. A deluxe figure that, you know, for some people, based on where you buy your figures from, could be $8 to $10 more than a regular release. This should have been a regular release. Despite that complaint, though, man, do I really like this figure. Of the four released so far of the main Bad Batch, this is my favorite one. I think it has the strongest sculpt. It's got the best likeness. I like the paint. It's a really striking figure. It is my favorite. Maybe it is worth the extra $8 to $10. Ugh. In any case, thanks for watching, everybody. Let me know in the comments below what you think of this figure. And if you want to be up to date with all my latest reviews, be sure to click subscribe.